I am Tiny Bassi. She's a Florida server, not ready to deport. Recent down orders, lots of fuel pressure, being through number two.
I'm an opera.
It's all about the tiki shorts. It's all about the tiki shorts.
Wow. All about rainbow flames, aren't you?
Ladies.
Yeah, you know, man.
Hey, it's me again. Thanks. Yeah, my Malaysia special.
No, I just like to hold the camera as long as I can in someone's face and see what they do.
It's
my turn.
Yeah.
No, it'd be cool. Yeah.
But yeah, awesome meeting them.
Yeah.
Bangers, get in here waiting for the post to come around so we can charge the hose and knock any of our people out of the room.
Ah, so it's a host team.
Skating.
Skating, correct.
Woman beg, and I make a good woman steal. I make an old woman blush, and I make a young girl squeal. I wanna be yours, pretty baby, yours and yours alone. I'm here to tell you, honey, that I'm bad to the bone. Bad, bad, bad.
To go, and it could happen tomorrow, it could happen next week, it might even be as long as about a month. I don't think it's going to take a whole lot longer than that. So be ready. And you should know in your heart of hearts that each and every one of you standing here today and your shipmates who are on watch throughout the ship, when this is all said and done, you will have something going for you that nobody else outside your Raven Gulf will have. You will have made a difference. What you're doing, what you're about to do, you're rewriting history. We will welcome the citizens of Iraq back into the League of Nations. There are millions of folks up there who have never tasted freedom. Because you're here, because of what you're about to do, that will change for them. think of how monumental an achievement that is. You know, when the champagne corks start hitting the ground and the ticker tape parades are all over when this is done, it has to matter to you. I know it matters to you. That the light of recognition burns most brightly where it matters the most. And that's inside each and every one of you. You'll know when this is said and done, you matter, that it couldn't have happened without you. You should be intensely proud of that. I am intensely proud of each and every one of you. I'm proud of your old man. We are counting on you. When the phone rings and he hears go, I'll tell you what, I don't know how much time we have. We've got all the time, I guess, we want. what fun is it if you can't abuse it? If there's anything on your mind that I can answer, we've got the Force Master Chief, R.J. Chapman, who here. He is here with me, thank goodness, today. He's going to come back in a couple days so he can pepper him with the hard questions. So give me a couple underhand slow pitch softballs right now, if anything's on your mind. Anything. Everybody all clear, set, ready? Okay, then I get to ask the question. Come here. No pressure. Should Pete Rose be in the Hall of Fame? No. Why not? Because he's a gambler? In kind of a shallow way, maybe. Do you know who Pete Rose is? You see? Straight, honest to goodness, unvarnished truth. That's why it's good for me to come out here. I don't always get that back home, believe me. Except wisely from my wife. Anything else? Anybody? It's all right. We'll still get headline privileges for liberty. Oh, by the way, liberty. That's the point. The old man talked to me about that a little bit before I came down. You all have been underway since 23 January, something like that, thereabouts. But yeah, what does it matter? Beer day is how many days away? 7-8 days, okay. Be ready. Take care of yourselves. Take care of your shipmates. Keep a weather eye out for the young man or woman next to you. You don't do us any good down in sick bay with a football stove up or a hand that's busted when the phone rings, and it's coming. Remember that you are making a difference, each and every one of you. Nobody can ever take that away from you. I'm proud of you. God bless you.
So proud of this crew, particularly for all the things that we do, but especially for our diversity and for the strength that it brings us. I have never been associated with a more diverse crew with more different backgrounds and more talent than that here as part of the Thundering Herd. And I think it shows the strength that comes from that for your performance and our ability to work together.
Welcome to the USS Calpis Black History Month. My name is Aishan Allen, and I'm here today to honor a great Black American civil rights leader by the name of Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Dr. King delivered this I Have a Dream speech on August 28, 1963 in Washington, D.C. to over 250,000 people. We still have a dream in spite of it all. We must have. Black History Month is a celebration of a world where anyone can overcome any odds through strength, unparalleled determination, and the power to dream.
Boy, why your head always be in those books? What you need to do is get your head out the clouds and come down to earth.
Mama, I told you, I'm on this entitled, but it's black to be black. The feeling of pain, sorrow, determination, and joy, all in one.
We are honored and humbled to share our thoughts with you in reference to our history and heritage. We are overjoyed to see the diversity of our crew take part in this celebration.
The first thing that I want to tell everyone, thank you for coming.
Welcome.
The reason why I'm saying that is it makes me proud. Here. Say never argue with ignorance because they will win by experience. Do not do that. Please.
Chief Gordon, me and Bo Jackson played football against each other.
Yeah, Tory
Small world.
Morning, everybody. Let me begin this by saying that I'm happy to be a part of this and everybody that has something, and everybody that has something to do with this making this possible. Thanks.
Good afternoon, don't know. My name is NC James. I am from what you call the hot sauce capital of the world, Louisiana. Some of you might pronounce it Louisiana, but that's wrong. I want you to know that.
Lean on Ong, I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on. Lean on me and
sing a song full of the faith that the darkness has taught us.
And now we'll do the dramatic presentation written by E.T.T. Talbot.
Hell no, he ain't free! All the things free here is this liquor bottle I got from the corner store.
All I'm saying is, times are different now. If you ain't slanging or bawling, you in the bin or 6 feet deep. Now you tell me the odds.
You may weigh me down in history with your bitter, twisted lies. You may trod me in the very dirt, but still, like dust, I'll rise.
Next is an original poem written by E.T.T. Talbert called The Negro Dilemma.
I have a poem called The Negro Dilemma. The taking of a mind, beaten as a rag doll, leaking stuff.
From ITS and Wooten.
This poem, it was written in the late 80s by the man of the name Jeffrey E. Warner. It has a lot of meaning to it, so everything that I say to you, take something out of it.
I'm protected.
What's going on?
First class service worker road rep for professional achievement and superior performance of his duties while serving as leading head officer in Bulk Store Room Custodian S2 Division. Masterfully balancing both responsibilities, he supervised the extensive renovation of the galley, mess decks, and offload and unload of over 450 line items to renovate the Bulk Store Rooms during the ship's SRA. His tireless efforts yielded a 100% inventory accuracy rate during the surprise audit during the Captain Edward F. May Award inspection, which directly resulted in Captain's winning the 2003 May Award.
Assemble all Chief Petty Officers and the Chief Petty Officers' Mess.
The Secretary of the Navy has awarded the Navy Marine Corps Achievement Medal to our Mess Management Specialist First Class Sabas for maintaining flawless accounting of over 450 items valued at over $140,000. She intensely reviewed all inspection criteria, meticulously verifying the accuracy of her records. Due to her extraordinary attention to detail and uncompromising integrity, all accountability records were 100% accurate and were judged as the best record system that May inspectors reviewed fleet-wide, directly resulting in Calpin's winning the 2003 May Award. Secretary of the Navy presents the Navy Marine Corps Achievement Medal to Mess Management Specialist First Class Virata for his duties while serving as leading mess management specialist. Thrust into the leading mess specialist position, he drove all aspects of food service operations in preparation for the Captain Edward F. May Award competition. Petty Officer Virata thoroughly reviews all inspection criteria, ensuring that all financial records, inventory, menu, and recipes and mess management indicators met or exceeded all May Award standards. Navy Marine Corps Achievement Medal is presented to Electronics Technician Second Class Robinson for his duties while serving as Mess Deck's Master at Arms. While in a position normally assigned to a senior first class petty officer, he demonstrated superb leadership skills in supervising 21 food service attendants and maintaining the sanitation and cleanliness of food service spaces. The following personnel have been awarded enlisted service warfare specialists. Professional skills and knowledge to be awarded enlisted service warfare specialists. GM2 Police Corps. ITQ Clark. ET2 Games. PCT Jordan. Thank you. GSM2 Python. PM2 Massive. EG2 Robinson. SM3 Barlow. ET3 Cisco. SH3 Davis. ET3 Dawson. ET3 Cavard. ET2 Rooster, EM2 Lopez, SH3 Seymour, Siemens and Charlie.
Okay, let's give a round of applause to our shipmates for this achievement.
Okay, you're protecting one of three carriers. You will keep us safe. All right? You'll also be given other responsibilities. You have a strike mission of your own. Okay? For all those involved in Tomahawk, there will be a pretty tremendous Tomahawk display in the early portion of the war.
No, I'm Captain Chuck Dixon, the commanding officer of the USS Cowpens. We're here on this cruise deployed to the 5th Fleet Area Responsibility, and here within hours, we have just learned that the President has laid down a ultimatum, if you will, and put a deadline for Saddam Hussein to finally be taken care of. It's unfortunate that it comes to this, but this is what we train for, and I am so proud of all of you, collective body of this ship, for all the hard work we did last year during the training cycle, all the hard work we did in making sure the equipment was ready to go through the SRA, and all the hard dedicated work that you do every day to keep your equipment ready and to keep your training on par. I know we're prepared to do whatever we're asked to do in the coming days. It gives me great confidence to serve with you and lead with you, and I know that you will rise to this challenge as it unfolds over the coming days and weeks. I look forward to sharing more messages with you, but for now, just be ready. That has been the constant theme from the President to the Secretary of Defense to our Battle Group Commander and 5th Fleet Commander. We hear it over and over again. The charge to each of us is to be ready, and I'm convinced we are ready. Thank you for your great dedicated service.
Executive Officer on board Cowpens. Just a few hours ago, the President put forth his ultimatum to Saddam Hussein that within the next 48 hours he had to leave the country, and otherwise we would use force to remove him. Obviously, the crew is ready. If we're going through our last minute review of procedures in case that we're called to act, it's looking more and more likely that we will. So I'm quite confident that in the next few days, if the thundering herd is called upon, they'll respond as they have in the past. The ship has a record of performing extremely well when called upon, and I have no doubt that when the moment comes, we'll be professional and execute our duty as called.
The United Nations Security Council has not lived up to its responsibilities, so we will rise to ours. In recent days, some governments in the Middle East have been doing their part. They have delivered public and private messages urging the dictator to leave Iraq so that disarmament can proceed peacefully. He has thus far refused. All the decades of deceit and cruelty have now reached an end. Saddam Hussein and his sons must leave Iraq within 48 hours. Their refusal to do so will result in military conflict, commenced at a time of our choosing.
Second time is about to tell the country that it is at war. He did it on a Sunday when the war in Afghanistan began in those months after 9/11. And in just a moment, he is about to do it again. Here is the president.
My fellow citizens, at this hour, American and coalition forces are in the early stages of military operations to disarm Iraq, to free its people, and to defend the world from grave danger. On my orders, coalition forces have begun striking selected targets of military importance to undermine Saddam Hussein's ability to wage war. We will meet that threat now with our Army, Air Force, Navy, Coast Guard, and Marines, so that we do not have to meet it later with armies of firefighters and police and doctors on the streets of our cities. Now that conflict has come, the only way to limit its duration is to apply decisive force. And I assure you, this will not be a campaign of half measures, and we will accept no outcome but victory. My fellow citizens, the dangers to our country and the world
will be overcome. We will pass through this time of peril and carry on the work of peace. We will defend our freedom. We will bring freedom to others, and we will prevail. May God bless our country and all who defend her.
Gentlemen, this is the real thing. This is what you've been trained for. You are America's best. Make us proud.
You bring me down, you take my way.
out, I guess it worked.
Department of Defense. The second table is set for one. The table would normally be round to show our everlasting concern for our men and women still missing. The tablecloth is white, symbolizing the purity of their motives when answering the call to duty. The single red rose displayed in a vase reminds us of the life of each of the missing, their loved ones and friends who keep the faith awaiting answers. The vase is tied with a red ribbon, a symbol of our continued determination to account for our missing. A slice of lemon on the bread plate is to remind us of the bitter fate of those captured or missing in a foreign land. A pinch of salt symbolizes the tears endured by those missing and their families who seek answers. The Bible represents the strength gained through faith to sustain those lost from our country, founded as one nation under God. The glass is inverted to symbolize their inability to share this meal. The chairs are empty. They are missing. I would like to ask you now to consider their sacrifices. Attention to the creed.
We are the lone sailors. I am the United States Senate. I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States of America and will obey all orders appointed over me.
I will defend the fighting spirit of the nation. All those who have gone before me and freedom and democracy around the world.
I proudly serve my country and Navy combat team with honor, courage, and commitment.
I am committed
to excellence and the fair
treatment of all. Right from me. I am the rightful for all prison war and missing national. I represent the prison war and missing national for yesterday and today. The rightful represents power of arms and the will to fight. The rifle epitomizes pride, honor, courage, commitment, and duty. Never done.
The flag bearer.
I am the lone flagman. I represent all those that have been lost and gone before me. Remember those.
Please be seated. Lieutenant Holcomb will now deliver the benediction.
Please join me once again. Dear Lord, as we leave today to go about our jobs, let those who are missing in action or who are prisoners of war be remembered. I ask you to watch over their families and loved ones while they are gone. Comfort their families and loved ones as they have to endure the many questions that remain unanswered. Bless them for the sacrifice that they have had to make. I ask this prayer in the strong name of the Lord. Amen.
As we
endure
our meal, may we take a moment and pause to remember those missing who cannot be with us today.
Me.
Hey, Sherman, how you doing?
Hey,
more chicken!
Chicken!
Right there.
Thank you.
Harry, I mean, carrots?
Yeah.
Can I say you never told me nothing?
Yeah.
You ready to go? No. You get the super duper hot ones? Are they mediocre?
They're warm.
They're warm?
Yeah, only in temperature though. Oh.
Yeah, I was up like 40 hours straight.
40 hours straight. I always had a hiccup for every time I heard that story.
But it's true this time.
Okay. What's up? Tomahawk? Chicken wings. See how it works, right? Holla. Big shot. What about you, Rick? Can you do a big shot?
Hey, yo, what's up?
You get the hot ones?
This is the real operations department. Couldn't line up if you paid them to.
You can do a lot of basic movement.
We'll do no marching maneuvers because it will be ugly.
Times are strange, here I come, but I ain't the same. Mama, I'm coming home. Time gone by, it seems to be, you could have been a better friend to me. Mama, I'm coming home. You took me in and you drove me out, yeah. Lost and found and turned around by the fire in your eyes. You made me cry, you told me lies, but I can't stand to say goodbye. Mama, I'm coming home. I could be right.
Sorry, sir, you're just a cab, let's dance all, and brother, all we've done, we are going to power it, it'll look great. Enjoy this.
Selfish love, yeah, we're both alone, right before the fall, yeah. But I'm gonna take this heart of stone, I just got to have it all. I've seen your face a hundred times. Every day.